Hello children, hope you are doing well. Now today we are going to learn the second chapter from your science book, and that is Human Body, the Teeth. Now while studying this chapter, we are going to learn the following concepts. Number one, sets of teeth. Number two, types of teeth and their position. Number three, structure and function of each type of tooth. Number four, parts of a tooth. Number five, tooth decay. And finally, number six, care of teeth and gums. And then we will do the exercise. Do you know why do we have teeth? We have teeth to bite and chew the food we eat. And they also help us to speak clearly. So, how do they help us? Teeth help us to eat our food and to speak clearly, isn't it? See, we all have teeth. But does the newborn child have teeth? No. Human babies are born without teeth. But by the age of 2 to 3 years, they have about 20 teeth. These first set of teeth are called milk teeth. They are also called the primary teeth or temporary teeth. Why do they call the temporary teeth? Because as the child grows, these teeth fall one by one. That is why the milk teeth are called temporary teeth. And in their place, a set of new, bigger and stronger teeth grow. This second set of teeth that comes after the temporary teeth fall are called permanent set of teeth, which we use through our whole life. There are 32 permanent teeth in an adult. We get our set of permanent teeth by the time we are 13 years old. So, what we have learned from this part? We have learned that when you were very small, at that time you had a set of 20 primary teeth or milk teeth. And now as you are growing, you are going to have a set of 32 permanent teeth. So, the primary teeth or temporary teeth, they are replaced naturally and replaced by the permanent teeth. But the permanent teeth are never replaced naturally. So now we will move to the second topic, that is types of teeth and their position. Now all our teeth are not of the same kind. They are of four kinds according to the types of work they do, like biting, tearing and chewing the food. The four types of teeth are incisors, canines, premolars and molars. Incisors are the cutting teeth. The front four teeth in the upper and lower jaw in our mouth are the incisors. They are flat and have sharp edge to cut or bite the food. Canines are the tearing teeth. One canine is present on both sides of the incisors on both the jaws. There are total four canines. They are sharp and pointed. In flesh-eating animals, they are bigger, stronger and sharp, which helps to tear the flesh. Premolars comes next to the canines. They are broad and flat. There are total 8 premolars. They help to crack and grind the food into fine pieces. Molars are bigger, flatter and broader teeth. There are 12 molars. They also help to crush and grind the food well. Plant-eating animals have well-developed premolars and molars. 8 molars appear first and four more molars grow later between the age of 17 and 25. They are commonly called wisdom teeth. Now, parts of a tooth. Let's see the basic structure of a tooth. It is common for all types of teeth. The different parts of a tooth are crown, root, enamel, dentine, pulp, and blood vessels. The part that can be seen or the visible part of the tooth is called the crown. And the lower part is called the root. The root fixes the tooth to the gums. The outer hard white layer of the crown is called the enamel. Enamel is the hardest substance in the human body. The layer under the enamel is called dentine. Inside the dentine, there is pulp which is very soft and full of nerves and blood vessels. The root is covered with a bone-like substance called cementum. It binds the root firmly to the gums and jaw bones. Do you know why the tooth is white in color? Because of its enamel. And the tooth is hard because of its dentine. Care of teeth. Do you all brush your teeth every day? Of course, yes. But why do you do so? Obviously, to keep them clean, otherwise it will decay. Why do teeth decay? When we eat food, tiny particles of food get stuck on the teeth and also in the space between the teeth. If we don't brush properly, the germs breed there. These germs feed on the food and produce acid. The acid destroys the tooth enamel and forms cavities in our teeth. If you do not brush regularly, a sticky, colorless layer full of germs and food particles grows on the surface of the teeth. This is called plaque. So, why should we take care of our teeth and gums? We must take care of our teeth and gums because our permanent teeth cannot be replaced naturally. So, they can get damaged and we may lose our teeth if we don't take care of them properly. Now, how do you take care of your teeth? Following are some of the ways to protect your teeth. Rinse your mouth every time after eating something. Brush your teeth at least twice a day, once in the morning and before going to bed. Use floss to clean between the teeth. Use tongue cleaners to clean the tongue. Brush using up and down motion. Avoid colas, too many sweets and snacks. Eat hard fruits like apple. Visit the dentist regularly for checkups. A dentist is a doctor who looks after our teeth. Calcium and phosphorus are the essential minerals to keep the teeth strong. Dairy products such as milk, curd, cheese, and foods such as soya, oranges, some seafoods are rich in calcium. Pumpkin seeds, nuts, fish, and eggs are rich in phosphorus. Toothpaste contains fluoride, a mineral that helps to strengthen teeth enamel and protect against decay. So this was the entire chapter, and the worksheets of this lesson will be provided to you separately. Thank you.